Good morning, my dear students. So this is the fifth class of economic entomology. This today's sections we are going to study detailly the digestive system of insects and digestion. So the digestive system of an insect or in any living organism, the role of the digestive system is to extract the nutrients that is needed for the growth and development and reproduction of any living organism. Similarly, the insects also a living organism. It need energy for their growth and the reproduction and for the day-to-day life. Therefore, that to extract the nutrients from the food or feed, we call it as whatever the insect consume as a raw material. So it has to break down into small particles. Through that, the chemical process, we call it as an catabolic reactions will happen. Through that, this will be converted into simple molecules, simple absorbable molecules. That's how the insect developed a machinery system, right? Like a machinery system. Whatever the raw material you are inserting, it will give an output, right? So system, see, we call it as a digestive system to break the complex material into simple form through the catabolic process. Then this catabolized product will be absorbed to use as an energy sources for the various purposes. So as like an other higher organism, insect digestive system is also a complete one. It's not a partial one. It's a complete one means, so food will move in one direction. It's a tube-like structure starting from the mouth where the insect are consumed, right? Taking the raw material, then it as the taken raw material has to store sometimes, then the enzyme won't act on that, then unwanted things have to remove from the system. So therefore, this elementary canal or the digestive system of an insect, it's a tubular structure. So starting from the mouth and end up with an anus. Right? The both sides are opening. So starting from mouth means oral cavity. Through that, the food is taken in and it's stored somewhere else like a stomach in human being. We call it as a crop. And it is processed and the unwanted things excreted through the anus. It's a lengthwise tube. So the digestive system is defined as an food processing occurs within the tube-like enclosure, we call elementary canal, running lengthwise through the body from mouth to anus. The elementary canal of an insect or the digestive system of an insect is subdivided into three functional regions. So the various functions are happening. So for the study purpose or the anatomically also is subdivided into three functional regions. So first part is we call it as a foregut, right? First part we call it as a foregut. It's a light blue color, foregut. From mouth to the end of the stomodial valve, we call it as a foregut. Or stomodium, foregut or stomodium. The second part is we call it as a midgut or mesenteron, where these enzymatic reaction and absorption can happen. Majority of the absorption can happen here, midgut. Third segment, right, third functional region, we call it as a hindgut or proctodium. Stomodium, mesenteron, proctodium, foregut, midgut, and hindgut. So these are the three functional regions of the digestive system of an insect. So if you are taking the how this digestive system originated, right? In the embryonic development, I told you in the last class, there are three germ layers, right? The three germ layers, so we call it as an ectodermal germ layer, endodermal germ layer. So there are two germ layer, ectodermal germ layer and endodermal germ layer. From these two germ layers, the foregut and the hindgut originated from ectodermal germ layer. It's called ectodermal origin, right? Here only you can find the cuticle. So cuticle also the ectodermal origin, so exoskeleton. So the cuticle will be present from end of the foregut to the end of these hindgut, the end of the midgut externally. There is no any cuticle or hardened part is not present in the midgut. The midgut originated from endodermal origin. Right? So there are three functional region in the digestive system. Ectodermal origin, foregut is ectodermal origin, midgut is an endodermal origin, hindgut is again ectodermal origin. So two germ layer form three functional region of the insect. Because this is important. Why? So this, if it is originated from the ectodermal or the ectodermal germ layer, then it is hardened. It's not allowing to absorb something. But in the midgut, if it is originated from the endoderm layer, it can absorbable. So thick cuticle will not go. There is no any cuticle. Here, the first and second, you can find a thin layer of cuticle. Therefore, that is not allowing to absorb the whatever the consumed. But if you are taking an insect digestive system, other than these three functional regions, this each and every functional region also you can find different components. So if you are taking the foregut, you can identify the oral cavity. In the oral cavity also you can find cibarium, salivary secretions, where it's working, and this salivarium and cibarium is just above, just in front of the pharynx. So you can find the cibarium. Next, behind the cibarium, you can find the pharynx. The pharynx joined with esophagus. Right, so in the label diagram, so you can find in the foregut, you can find salivarium, cibarium, and pharynx. The pharynx connecting the another tube-like structure we called as an esophagus. Right? The esophagus connecting with an crop. This is a stomach-like structure found in the higher animals. Right? Stomach, some of this is their main role is storage. This crop and joined with the midgut, and then another valve-like structure we call it as a phyllorus or stomodial valve. Here you can find the proventriculus, right? Here you can find just above the phyllorus, you can find in between crop and the phyllorus, you can find proventriculus. In some insect, this proventricular protruded into the midgut region as well. This is a midgut region. So this is the hindgut region. In the hindgut also, you can find in between the midgut and hindgut, you can find another valve we call it as a cardiac valve. and you can find the Malbigian tubules here. So you can find the hindgut also. There are three regions: ileum, rectum, and anus. Ileum, rectum, and anus. So these are the major component of the digestive system. So if you are taking more deeper, you can find there are so many things, and each and every parts that has been labeled here. You can identify each and every labeled part from this picture. That is helping to understand each and every anatomical part of a digestive system of an insect, starting from mouth. So therefore, that's what the mouth parts also labeled here. So this in digestive system also, in the digestive system also, you can find some anatomical modification. It varies with insect to insect and insect stages. That's how these two pictures showing. The first one is a digestive system of caterpillar. So you cannot find several modifications. It's a whole tube-like structure. But here, if you are comparing with that another milkweed bug, here you can find so many cavity-like structures because this is a liquid feeder. This is a solid feeder. So this is liquid feeder. Therefore, it needs so much space to draw the liquids. Right? So because from the liquid, insect can extract few amount of insect. That's why it consume more amount of liquid. This is an anatomical modification. You can find the different stages and according to the food habit also. Solid feeder and liquid feeder. So we will see from the foregut. So foregut is an anterior evagination. Anterior, as I told you, is an anterior evagination of the ectoderm. Ectoderm joined together, right? Evagination. This is called evagination. And the form foregut. In the foregut, thin cuticular line you can expect. Thin cuticular line you can expect this purple color. This is a part of cuticle. Or exoskeleton. That's how it is a hardened one. It is not allowing to absorb nutrition from the food. That is for protection, right? That is for protection. So terminal mouth parts lead to a preoral cavity. So in the foregut, you can find the terminal mouth parts. These terminal mouth parts forming the preoral cavity. In the preoral cavity, you can find an epipharynx and hypopharynx joined together or in between, right? In between these epipharynx and hypopharynx, you can find a structure we called as a cibarium. And just between the hypopharynx and salivary duct, we call it as a cibarium, right? So the behind the mouth, this is the mouth. Behind the mouth wall, we call it as a pharynx. The next picture, it will show very clearly, right? So here you can find some mouth. In the mouth, you can find this is a pharynx. This is esophagus. Right? This is an esophagus. So the pharynx is a well-muscled one. Right? Well-fuzzled one. Well-muscled one. Therefore, whatever the food is there in the oral preoral cavity, it is pulling and pushing backward, right? Pulling and pushing backward into the esophagus. Pulling and putting back into the esophagus. The pharynx act as a cibarium, right? Pharynx act as a cibarium in the sev feeders. The liquid, solid feeders, it acts as a pharynx. So that's how you can find several scrotized tooth-like structures present in the pharynx and the esophagus. This is in the solid feeders, not in the liquid feeders. The liquid feeders, pharynx act as a cibarium, a sucking pump. Right? Sucking pump. Pharynx act as a cibarium. called as a sibarial pump. So next to the pharynx, you can find an esophagus. It's a narrow tube. Here, the narrow tube in this esophagus role is also pushing the food backward towards the crop for storage. In this esophagus also, you can expect so many round muscles to pull the food and push into the crop. It's a very narrow tube. Then the next region we call it as a crop is a part of esophagus, both, but it's an enlarged region, right? It's a part of esophagus, but it's an enlarged region. We call it as a crop. In this crop, you can find well sclerotized tooth-like structures to break the food, right? To break the food and so straw the food. And also sometimes you can expect that act as a storage of liquids by some modification. So this is we call it as a crop. This main role is to straw the food. Just behind the crop, you can find proventriculus or gizzard. Proventriculus or gizzard. This is a structure. This is a crop. Esophagus and crop. So in just behind the crop, you can find the gizzard or proventriculus. The proventriculus is a very hardened structure. It is well muscled in the saphenous, but it's very hardened, sclerotized structure present. Its main role is to grind the food. So some insects, solid fooders, so grind, so 6 hexagonal pad will be there. You can find this here, rectal pad, right? Hexagonal pad. So this hexagonal pad, just grinding, right? Just grinding the food. In honeybee, it is a plate-like structure, just prevent the movement of the pollen and allow the nectar to go into the honey stomach. The crop modified into form a honey stalk. The pollen, it will be stored. It will not allow to go the pollen into the honey stomach. That's the main role of this proventriculus in honeybees. The spine-like structure. Why spine-like structure present in the blood-sucking insects, especially flea. You can find to break the blood cells. So this movement of the food from the crop to midgut, it controlled by a valve. I already explained that controlled by a valve-like structure present in the end of the proventriculus, we call it as a cardiac valve or esophageal valve. Right, cardiac valve or esophageal valve, or sometimes it called as a stomodial valve, right? Sometimes it called it as a stomodial valve or cardiac valve or esophageal valve. So pylorus valve here, this one is pylorus valve. But I've seen that in the first picture here, pyloric valve, stomodial valve or cardiac valve. Right, cardiac valve or stomodial valve, or sometimes we call it as esophageal valve. That's a controller, right? That's a controller. Here, this is a plate or pad-like structure for grinding purposes or breaking purposes. It is present in the proventriculus. This is the end of the foregut. The next section is a midgut. Midgut or mesenteron here, this region, red colored one, right? Midgut, or sometimes it call it as a stomach in the high animal, right? Midgut or ventriculus. So this is proventriculus. This one sometimes called as a ventriculus, or we call it as mesenteron or midgut. This is an endodermal origin. I told you this is an endodermal origin. So therefore, you cannot expect any sclerotized structure. As like intima is present in the foregut and hindgut, here there is no any intimas in the cuticular lining. This is a sac-like structure. No? This is modified. You can find some insect. It has been modified. The main role of this one is that secretion of these enzymes, digestive enzyme, to digest the food material is coming from the crop. Right? Coming from the crop. Sac-like structure, sometimes coil-like structure, sometimes tubular structure. So it depends on the type of insect and type of food. So internally lined with an epithelium. Epithelium is important for secretions. There is no any epithelial cell in the foregut and the hindgut. But in the midgut only you can find epithelium instead of cuticle or intima. Thin line of cuticle or intima you can find epithelium. This epithelium consisting, there are three types of cells. Columnar cells, right? Or columnar or cylindrical cell. Regenerative cells and goblet cells. You would have studied in the physiology to anatomy of the muscles in the advanced level, right? Columnar cells, regenerative cells, and goblet cells. The main role of this one is to excrete here, right? In the epithelial cells. This is an epithelial cell. In the epithelial cells also, you can find the excretion, right? Excretion. Three types of cells present. Main role is to excretion of enzymatic, the digestive enzyme. In the midgut region also, other than this main sac or main tube, you can find some evaginations and occlusions. Right? So one is peritrophic envelope. This peritrophic membrane means it is forming inside the sac. Right? Inside the sac, it is forming immediately after food intake. It's a temporary one. It is not permanent one, right? So it is present in the solid feeders, absent in liquid feeders, right? The peritrophic membrane formed immediately after the food intake in the solid food feeders, not in the liquid feeders. The main role of this peritrophic membrane or peritrophic envelope, we call it as, role is to lubricate. So lubricating, giving some moisture to the ground food to mix with the, to facilitate the mixing of the within enzymes. And second, to protect the midgut epithelium. So because sometimes that food material consisting very hardy spine parts or porous parts. If you are eating the bone, some insect are eating the insect, another insect. If they are eating the another insect, this insect food may contain skeletons. It's very hardy, very minute, very hardy structures. You can find it. So therefore, it can damage the midgut epithelium. Therefore, to protect the midgut epithelium, this peritrophic envelope is formed in the solid feeding insect. This peritrophic envelope is not allowing the food to touch with the epithelial cells. Just is a compartmentalization of the ground food in the midgut, but it is a semi-permeable, allowing to move to the enzyme, epithelial membrane secreted enzyme into the envelope, and allowing this digestive food, digested food to absorb, right? Digestive food to absorb. Another segment, it's a true part of the midgut, it is there, you can find the gastric cecum. The gastric cecum is a finger-like structures. Sometimes you can find an evagination, curve-like structures. Sometimes it can be modified into diverticula of anterior and posterior in different insect groups, right? Subfeeders or solid feeders. its major role is to increase the surface area for digestion. Second one, this cica, you can find so many microorganisms. This microorganism giving, helping to digest, further digestion of certain molecules. Certain you will study later. Another region is the phyloric valve. I told you the phyloric valve here. This phyloric valve there. This valve regulates the food material to go into the intestine-like structure in the hindgut. Intestine-like structure, the hindgut, and also not allowing the movement of liquid into that directly while digesting. After the digestion only, it will allow. That's what we call it as a pyloric valve or proctodial valve. This is the proctodian, of course. The proctodial valve is just controlling the movement of the food material from the midgut to hindgut. It is present. This one is not connected with the midgut, is not connected with the hindgut in certain insects. For example, if you're taking the honeybee grub, jung one of the honeybees, it's not connected. That means this jung ones will not produce excreta. Whatever they're taking, your whole absorb. Right? The whole absorb. This is, there are three regions found in the midgut. Another segment is also there, some insect group we call as a filter chamber. This filter chamber is a complex organ. It's an end-to-end joint in between the midgut and hindgut. Right? So we call it as a ventriculus and the hindgut, midgut and hindgut, right? In the ventriculus, it's an enclosed sac-like structure. The main role of this one, shortcut to transfer the excess water. If there is some excess water in the food material, so it will dilute more food now. So therefore, what will the insect, if it is having the filter chamber, move the water from here directly to the here, not in midgut. Therefore, the insect, solid insect, this filter chamber helping to solidify the food more by filtration of this water from the food, excess water. This shortcut, moving here to there, the liquid feeding insects, right? This helps to osmoregulation, preventing the dilution of hemolymph, right? Prevent the dilution, because if this going to filter the water now, if this hemolymph potential, osmotic potential is less, then water will be absorbed very quickly from this filter chamber. Therefore, there is a midgut consisting four part. One is temporarily petrophic envelope. Other three important parts are cica, right? Gastric cica, pylorus, and filter chamber. So this is a midgut. So midgut is an endodermal origin. You cannot expect this endodermal origin in other two functional region of the elementary canal, foregut or hindgut. The main role of this midgut is to absorption, digestion and absorption. That's what they are having the cica and filter chamber to reduce the liquidity in the food. Here the cica, if you are taking the anterior cica, you see so much of evaginations are there. If it is evaginated one, it is increasing the surface area here. 28,500 millimeter square. This area is 28,500 millimeter square. You see, find it. But if it is not evaginated, you see 8,000 millimeter square. Therefore, their role is the cica to increase the surface area for absorption, because it's consisting so much of microorganism. So microbial digestion will happen. Once the microbial digestion happens, it is will be absorbed through this. This is a peritrophic envelope. You see, there is no connection between this epithelium and the peritrophic envelope. This is a gut. Inside, you can find the gut, food. It's a gut. It's a gut. It's a peritrophic envelope. This is an epithelium of the gut. Right? So lumens, so this papilla also present in the epithelial cells. Other than these three types of cells, columnar cell, regenerative cells, and goblet cells, you can find there are so many microvilli. Right? So many. So microvilli is there. So this is giving absorption. This is giving increase the region for absorption. So the inside this one you can find. This is a cross section of the body, right? Cross section of the body. Here, sometime this I told you the proventriculus, it is just protruded into the midgut also. That's how this proventriculus, it's not differentiable. Certain liquid feeding insect. One such example is so honeybee and ant. You cannot find this proventriculus. So it is located in between this protruded. This starting with the foregut and protruded into the midgut for different purposes. The last functional segment of the alimentary canal is a hindgut. Hindgut is also of an ectodermal origin. You cannot find any thin cuticle-like intima, but it is bit more permeable than the foregut. Foregut is not permeable. This intima cuticle just allowing to move the molecule to absorb by the hindgut. Right, absorbed by the hindgut, salt, anion, amino acid. What are the functions happening in the high animal hindgut or large and small intestine? This is happening same in insect too. We call it as a hindgut. The main function is absorption of water. That's how you find it. The filtration chamber is joined directly from foregut to hindgut, while the midgut is in between this one, just passing the water. Because if the water need for absorption is absorbed into the intestine, hindgut, right? Absorbed into the hemolymph. And also other useful substances from the fecal material. So insect is not like to waste any material. Whatever the material, food material is there, as much energy as could they will take from that food. Therefore, any other useful substance is present in the after the complete digestion. So from the fecal material, so maybe water and salt and iron, other things absorb and forming a uric acid. So this water is not much present in the urine because this is in our is just a urea, but here is an it is converted into uric acid. Therefore, it is removing with the fecal matter, as like the poultry birds, right? So Malpighian tubule, just the connection, the junction in between the midgut and the hindgut, you can find certain tubule like structure we call it as a Malpighian tubules, where this uric acid is formed, right? Malpighian tubule, where the uric acid is formed. So this pylorus valve you can find between the midgut and hindgut. This is a part of midgut, but it is also present in the junction. The midgut here, there are some modification. The hindgut, there are some modification. Malpighian tubules here. The Malpighian tubules here too. Here you see so much of Malpighian tubules. And cica, you see on lot of cica. Here also you see 1 or 2 cicas. But it is differ with insect to insect. This hindgut also divided into 3 segments. Or functional region. 3 functional region. Ileum, column, and rectum. Ileum, column, and rectum. In the recta is modified into fermentation chamber. Right, the recta is modified into fermentation chamber in some insect. But ileum sorry, not rectum, ileum is modified into some pouch like fermentation sucker, where you can find the microbial digestion will happen, and some insect, they are growing certain microorganism by giving the food, and this chamber acts as an anaerobic fermentation chamber. Anaerobic fermentation, otherwise this microorganism will not work if it is an anaerobic condition. No. So therefore, this microorganism, these insects are giving suitable anaerobic condition to work this microorganism. Right? This is we called as a fermentation chamber, where these insects are growing certain fungals. For example, if you are taking the termite, you can find they are cultivating certain fungi inside the fermentation. Certain scarabids, ambrosia beetle, right? We call it as an ambrosia beetle, a short call borer. They are cultivating ambrosia fungus in the fermentation. The name is called ambrosia fungus. So rectum contains rectal pad. Here, there are six rectal pad, 2, 4, 6 rectal pad. This is prevent the dehydration. So controlling the fecal removal. Rectal pad is controlling the fecal removal through the anus. So because this is very tightened one, so not allowing the dehydration. If it is open one, dehydration will happen. Here, the hindgut and the crop and the midgut, how it is modified in certain insect groups. For example, this and butterfly is a nectar feeder. Crop is modified as an evagi. You see evagination in the above this main canal. Just nectar will go here. Caterpillar, you see, just like a tube-like structure. The termite, you can find here the so this ileum is modified as a punch, a fermentation chamber. Here, fermentation chamber in the scarabid. Fermentation is a termite, punch-like structure. This modification according to the insect group and their type of food they are consuming. Here also you can see certain diverticulum is there because this is a liquid. Myraschia is a liquid feeder. Right? Liquid feeder, because this diverticulum and crop is modified as a tubes. Lot of tubes because they are ingesting more amount of liquids. So liquids consisting less amount of nutrition. That's how they are taking more amount of nutrition, the more amount of liquid. So right, this is Rhodinus. That anterior midgut is modified is like that. Posterior midgut. You see the anatomical modifications are there. It varies with insect to insect. So this is the end of the section of digestive system. So you want to ask any questions, you can ask for 1 or 2 minutes, then we can continue the digestion of in insects. So this is an end of the digestive system. The next one is a digestion and absorption in insects. So normally, you will know this primary function of the digestive tract is to absorb the nutrition and the metabolite from the food. Right? This digestion process facilitated by digestive enzymes and microorganisms present in the insects. You will know the digestive enzymes secreted by salivary gland as well as midgut epithelium, right? Salivary glands and midgut epithelium. Microbes you can find in the ceca and the fermentation chamber, pouch-like structure in termite. Fermentation chamber, pouch-like structure, and ceca. In these three regions, you can find microorganisms. Enzymes are produced by salivary glands and midgut epithelium in the midgut. Why these insects are producing enzyme in two regions? Because digestion starting in some insects externally, so outside of the body. Some insect, it is starting just in the midgut. So therefore, these enzymes are produced in different insect group in different areas. But if you're taking high animals, so saliva, partial digestion is happening in the while mixing the food in the saliva in human, right? Complete is happening in the stomach, like that. Okay, because digestion, so the digestion, why it is important? If the insect ingests a food, it may consisting of macromolecules, proteins, polysaccharides, lipids, and phospholipids, glycolipids, and different types of lipids, and wax, cellulose. So many things. This we call it as a macromolecule. These macromolecules are not readily absorbable for. So therefore, these macromolecules have to be converted into simple absorbable form, simple molecules. Therefore, this digestion is happening in insect by using the two major components, right? So in two major components are involving, one component is an enzyme involving. So enzymes you can find saliva in midgut and microorganism involved digestion. After completion of this enzymatic digestion, microorganism will work, right? You should remember, some insect, only this part. If the microorganism is involving the digestion process, so both will happen, that insect, right? You should remember that. So saliva, if you want to study about the enzymes of the saliva and the midgut, you should know about that, what are the enzymes and how it is secreted, enzyme in the saliva and the salivary glands and midgut, right? So in the salivary glands, you can find that a pair of salivary glands are present in the, just behind the mouth. You would have seen that in the second pictures, right? This is the salivary gland. Right? The salivary gland producing saliva, it will come out and open in the salivarium of the mouth cavity, preoral cavity. Salivarium of the preoral cavity. If the food is coming, it is mixed with there, it will go. In some insect, produce saliva, it ejected into the food. For example, flies ejected into the food. Digestion is happening outside the body, then sucking. From next digestion will happen here. Right? That's what, this is something different in insect. Right? So, pair of salivary glands. The salivary glands are modified in some insect group in differently. For example, if you are taking caterpillars, mandibular glands, instead of the salivary glands, mandibular gland is modified as a salivary gland. Right? Mandibular glands are modified into secrete the saliva. In some insect, this mandibular gland secretion, so salivary gland secretion silk, or silkworm. They are producing silk, no? The saliva is silk. The function of the major function of the saliva is, in majority of the insect, moisten the food. It's the same process as, no? While we are eating, it starts moisten the solid food. Dry food is get moist. In the moist only the enzyme can act on. No? So moisten and dissolve the food and lubricate the mouth parts. It's giving the lubrication. Otherwise, it may cause injuries, no? Mouth parts. Or in insect too, it's giving the lubrication system. It's act as a lubrication system, oil for mouth parts. And add flavor and the gustatory receptors. So saliva or salivary gland secretion can help to insect to taste the flavors, right? Taste the flavors and add the flavors to the food. The function of the saliva varies with insect to insect, right? The cockroach saliva, the main role is it's consisting amylase. If it is consisting amylase, it means digestion of starch. We're taking the honeybee saliva, it consisting invitases because they are taking the sucrose. No? So they act on the invitases, work on the sucrose and digesting the sucrose into glucose. And jacids, right, in the jacid insect, it's a sap feeders, saliva contain lipases and proteases. This is for lipid and protein digestion, no? Lipid and protein digestions. So other than this enzymes, they sometimes these saliva consisting of certain chemicals, they are toxic to plants. You will study this one in the pest sciences. Right? Pest sciences, toxic. That's what it's creating injury to the plant. The bugs, certain bugs saliva containing pectinases. Because if their food source contains high amount of pectin, so they consist of pectinases to dissolve the pectin. And it will help to penetrate their stylet. Pectin is not allowing, right? In between the cell, the wall consisting of pectinate. Right? So to break the pectin, so this excrete the saliva consisting of pectinases, and then it can inject. The mosquito saliva consists anticoagulin to prevent the coagulation of blood. That's how the blood can suck continuously, right? So the different insect groups, saliva act as a different functions, right? That's how it's explained. The gall midge is a dipteran consisting indole acetic acid. If the saliva is consisting indole acetic acid, this is also common in nematode as well. If the saliva is ejected, excreted into the plant, if it is consisting indole acetic acid, then it modified the cells. Cells become again cells, right? Gall formation is because of this indole acetic acid. Some vectors, some hoppers, so they are saliva, they are having the pathogens. In the saliva, they're consisting certain pathogens, so that's what they act as a vectors for transmission of the pathogen, sap feeders, hoppers. So this is a function of saliva. The main role of the saliva is moisten the food, lubricate, and add the flavor. So different insect group, this saliva is working and doing different roles. The gut secretions, you can find it, right? Gut secretion, you can find it. So in the hepatic cecum. So hepatic cecum is produced, and multi-epithelial cells, midgut epithelial cells are involving to produce digestive juices, enzymes. Saliva also consisting digestive enzyme. In the midgut also consisting, producing digestive enzymes. So in the midgut epithelial, you can find there are two cells, holocrine and macrocrine. Right? Holocrine and macrocrine. The holocrine means epithelial cell disintegrate in the process of enzymes secretion. While enzymes producing, epithelial cell is dying. We call it as an holocrine cells. Macro, right? So another one is there, the mirocrine cells. The mirocrine cells releasing the enzymes by breaking the cells. Cells is bursting and enzyme is released into the midgut. So this is, therefore in the midgut, enzymes are produced by cecum and midgut epithelial cells. And extra-intestinal digestion. I told you, so digestion is happening outside of the body, inside of the body. The extra-intestinal digestion means saliva and midgut excretion, especially saliva, 99% saliva, ejected into the food. The saliva work on the food and it is digested. Then the digested food content is sucked. Right? Digested food content is sucked. So therefore, this is we call it as an extra-intestinal digestion. Right? We call it as an extra-intestinal digestion. It is happening some of these insect groups. For example, Hemiptera, some of the adult Acylida, Dipteran, the Neuroptera, can happen. The digestive enzymes, you can find it. These are the digestive enzymes produced by the insect groups. Certain insect group, in which substrate they act on. For example, amylase on starch, maltase and maltose, inpertase and sucrose, protease and protein. So this insect group, phytophagous insect, amylases. Omnivorous insect, proteases. Some in the predatory insect, they are, no? They will consume more prey consisting more protein. No? They need proteases and lipases. Nectar feeders insect, you can find invertases. And wood boring insect, they are consuming more amount of cellulose. No? To digest the cellulose, they are cultivating that microorganism. Microorganism producing more amount of cellulases. Then cellulose is get digested. As like in the ruminants, animals. Right? The meat-eating maggots mainly producing collagenases. The bird lices, they are producing keratinases. They are because working on keratin. So these are the digestive enzyme producing different insect groups according to the feeding habit and materials consumed. Then third is a microbial digestion. The microbial digestion means it is happening in the pouch-like structure in the termite, and chamber-like structure is present in some scarabid beetles, right? So these are the microorganisms. These microorganisms are symbiotic relationship with the body cell wall. We call it as a mycetocyte, right? These few cells act as a symbiotic microorganism. So they are symbiotic relationship with this microorganism, certain cell wall of the chamber. We call it as a mycetocyte. This mycetocyte aggregate to form organ called mycetome. That's the chamber of pouch. This chamber of pouch, you can find this microorganism. One is flagellate protozoa. This flagellate protozoa, it is there in the rumen of the livestock. No, you would have studied in the anatomy and physiology of farm animal. Flagellate protozoa. They are producing more amount of cellulases. That's how the cellulose-eating insect, termites, quickly digest the cellulose material. Some bacteria, it is present in the cica, help for wax digestion, the wax moth. Wax digestion, the wax moth. Some bedbug and cockroach, from this microorganism, they are obtained vitamin and amino acids because they are producing certain secondary metabolites inside the gut. No, they are releasing. From that, they are taking vitamin and amino acids. The microbes from adult to young one, it is transferred through the mouth-mouth food exchange or through the egg-to-egg transmission. This is called as an transovarial transmission. Because young one get the offspring of this adult should get these microorganisms, the termite, they are having the digestive microorganism. This microorganism, how these young ones will get through the transovarial transmission. These are extra intestinal digestion, mean the excretion of saliva into the food and absorb. It's happening outside the body. This is in the gadolinium. Butterflies, carbohydrate proteins, it is only in the gadolinium. There is no any external. So then we will study how these each and every macromolecules get digested. The protein digestion, so you can see the protein consistent exopeptidases and endopeptidases. So ectopeptide molecule and endopeptide molecule will be disintegrated by using the ectopeptidases and endopeptidases. Other than that endopeptidases, so you can find certain different molecules will be there. Serine proteases, trypsin and chymotrypsin. These are the amino acids. Right? These amino acids are produced by breaking the endopeptidase molecule bond of these proteins. The carbohydrate digestion, you see polysaccharides and disaccharides converted into monosaccharides. cellulose is disintegrated into glucose by through the series of cellulose digestion. This is microbial microorganism involved digestion. The cellulose digestion, as you see, so cellulose digestion, its cellulose is very hardy. So enzyme cannot disintegrate. That's how microorganism, they are consisting, the insect, they are consisting microorganism will produce more amount of cellulases. The cellulases in three class enzymes for hydrolysis. Three classes of enzymes involved for the hydrolysis. Endogluconases, exogluconases, beta glucosidases. And in the cellulose molecule, if you are taking, this is biochemistry, right? If you are taking the cellulose molecule, the cellulose molecules, you can find endogluconases, exogluconases, and three beta glucosidases. These three molecules will be there. These molecules will be break by producing these three enzymes, endoglucan, exoglucan, beta glucoside. These three molecules will be disintegrated by producing these three types of enzymes. So here, this cellulose is digested is in by using the protozoa and flagellate protozoa and fungi and bacteria and termite, some scarabit and cockroaches, not in the other insect. In this insect also, you can find this fermentation chamber and pouch-like structure and the cica consisting microorganisms. So wood wasps, you can find cellulose digestion. This is a larval Cerambycidae, you can find longhorn beetle, ambrosia beetle. This beetle, we call it as they are cultivating fungi, ambrosia fungi, I told you, short cold borer. Lipid digestion. Lipid also you can find, this is nectar feeding insect or liquid feeding insect, they are absorbing more amount of lipids. So lipid consisting of long chain fatty acids and short chain fatty acids. The long chain fatty acids and short chain fatty acid disintegrated, then this, because through the lipases, then these lipases will converted into, lipids will be converted into sucrose, then it will be absorbed. Right, it will be absorbed. For those macromolecules to break, the midgut environment should maintain certain conditions. If you are taking an insect midgut, mainly this midgut pH varies with according to the food intake. For example, normally the insect pH is alkaline. Our pH, body pH, our midgut pH is acid. Insects are alkaline pH. So if the insect is eating pH, rich pH, pH is declining. You see? pH is declining towards acids. If they are eating after glucose eating, pH decline, increase to 4.5 to 4.8. It's in the cockroaches. But if you are taking the mosquito, you see, pH rise to 7.3. pH increases. Taking the protein, pH is increasing. Taking the carbohydrate, pH is decreasing. Right? So this is varies with insect to insect. That's how nowadays the scientists are developing insecticides based on this midgut pH. Midgut pH. So one such example is you all know about the BT. BT microorganism, they are producing endotoxin by a BT toxin. This toxin coat, protein coat, will be dissolved in alkaline pH. That's how these BT toxins are working in insects. Not in human being or other animals, because in other animals, midgut pH is acid. That's how the protein coat will not disintegrate it. Right? It will not disintegrate those. That's how we are safe. That's how this microorganism, the other insects are dying through the BT toxin. because they are alkaline pH. But according to the food, this is a research finding, right? Normally, pH environment, midgut of the pH is alkaline. This is a research of these two insects indicating that according to the different food, if it is insect taken in, the midgut pH is fluctuating. That is an I message. Temperature. So normally, the maximum range of temperature is 35 to 45 degrees. If the temperature is declining this one, and or if it is going above this one, the enzymes will not work very efficiently. You know, if it is more than the 45, enzyme will disintegrate it. If these enzymes will disintegrate it, then there is no digestion. If it is environmental temperature is declining and declining, declining, so the fast working of enzyme, the rate of enzyme, the working, the right working speed of the enzyme will be also declined. So therefore, in the temperature also want to work between 35 to 45, it's a maximum. From the, so an optimum level normally 22 to 29. It's an optimum range of temperature. The insect, the enzymes can work very efficiently. If the maximum is 35 to 45, its minimum is below 4 degree. The below 4 degree, enzyme will not work. And the redox potency, oxidation and the reduction. Oxidation and the reduction we call it as a redox potential. So normally, high positive potential you can expect, right? The positive, I mean oxidizing condition, if these food molecules are getting oxidized, right? Oxidized, high positive potential you can expect. If the molecules is want to reduce, go to the reduced conditions, I mean for example, if the insects are taking in different chemicals, the ferrous and ferric like that, ferrous and ferric like oxidized and redox condition. So the redox potential, if the insect, if the food is getting oxidized, then the positive potential will be high in the midgut. The insect or substrate is getting reduced, negative potential, redox, the reduction condition will be prevailing in the midgut. This is this condition is important for food substrate getting oxidized, right? For oxidation and reduction of the substrate material. Once it is digested, then absorption will be taken in insect. So the absorption can be in two forms, passive absorption and active absorption. Active absorption means by using the energy. Passive absorption means according to the osmopotential variation. Right, in the absorption, you see the midgut and rectum. Major water is absorbed in the midgut and rectum, no, mainly rectum. Right, mainly, not the rectum, it's a hindgut. The ileum is mainly there, water is absorbed, no. If the water is absorbed into the hemolymph water potential will be high, therefore the food material is absorbed in passive. Right, the water molecule is released, is not absorbing, then insect need energy to absorb the material. This is, we call it as an active absorption. Right? This active and passive absorption also depend on the food material consumed. Right? Food material consumed. Normally, the gut active absorption will be happen, not passive. Passive absorption will happen in the hindgut. Right? Midgut in active absorption, hindgut in passive absorption. Absorption in amino acids. Amino acids, so according to the concentration gradient, passive gradient diffuses from the midgut to hemolymph. Right? If it is in proteins get disintegrated, amino acid concentration will be high in the midgut, no? So then it will go higher potential to low potential. It will diffuse through the midgut epithelium. It go into the blood. Carbohydrate. Right? Carbohydrate is absorbed mainly as a monosaccharide, sucrose. Right? So from the high concentration of the gut to low concentration in the hemolymph, again it is a passive. Again it is a passive absorption. Lipids. So lipids, is broken into, right? So as a fatty acid, they are absorbed as a fatty acid. Long chain fatty acids is broken into short chain fatty acids. The short chain fatty acids will be absorbed as a fat globules, right? As a fat globules. So fat globules of the absorbed in the posterior zone of the midgut, right? Posterior zone of the midgut in the and incorporated into phospholipids and triglycerides. Phospholipids and triglyceride in the form they are absorbing. It's a short chain fatty acid. This is absorbed in the active form. Another one is the inorganic ions. So inorganic ions also absorbed according to the gradient. Potential is a passive absorption. So because if the inorganic ion is higher in the midgut region due to the food, then absorbed into the blood. So mainly carbohydrates and inorganic ions, amino acids are absorbed and water are absorbed in the passive way. Lipids are active in absorbed into the active way because lipids are deposited immediately after the absorption into the blood. It is converted into and deposited. That's what the concentration according to the concentration gradient variation, fat will not be absorbed. It's an active absorption. So this is an end of section of the digestion and digestive system of the insect and the digestion in insect. So if you won't ask any questions, so you can ask.